Welcome to Go Get It. Continuing on the SLR parser, which we have discussed in the previous session, we have seen that we were placing the reduce entries or the reduce actions in the SLR parsing table based on the follow set calculation. But that procedure leads to some wrong answers or wrong solutions, because follow set may contain more number of elements than the actual look ahead. And hence scientists derived the new parser called as CLR, canonical LR1 parser, where we will be calculating the look ahead symbol based on the production. So every production will have a separate look ahead symbol associated with it. Now we'll directly jump into the problem solving for CLR parser. Let's see this, how it differs from the SLR parser. So CLR parser is it leads to more memory consumption, because it will generate more number of states as the look ahead symbols are associated with the production, and with different states it will vary, the look ahead symbols will vary from state to state. Now let us assume the given grammar. We have S, capital C, capital C, then capital C. We have A and C. Again, we have D. So this is the given grammar. So we'll follow the same procedure, whatever we followed for other grammars. We'll create the canonical, the augmented grammar here. So we'll get S, C, C, and similarly, we'll get this. Now in CLR parser, the difference being, we will be passing the look ahead symbol here for every production, and based on this look ahead symbol during the reduce actions, we will place the reduce actions based on this look ahead symbol. So now let's draw the DFA for this. So the please concentrate on the deduction of this, how we deduce this LA, the look ahead symbol for the individual production. So we have S dash and dot S. Now being an accepted state, or the this production has been added to signify the accepted state of the finite automata. So this will always be dollar. Dollar means the empty string. That means this state or this production will accept the whole string. That's why this look ahead symbol will be denoted by dollar. Now this dot is before S, so that leads to generate include the S, this production also. S tends to capital C, capital C. So we get capital C. Now we have to calculate the look ahead of this production. Now you can see that this S tends to CC has been generated because of this. So in such case, what we will do, we'll calculate the first of or the follow of S, follow of this S, that will lead to, you can notice here that follow of S will lead to first of epsilon comma dollar, that will give you dollar. Now why epsilon? Epsilon is nothing but after S, you can see there are no other symbol, that's why we are considering epsilon. So we can directly say that we are placing here dollar as a look ahead symbol for this. Now this dot is before C, so we'll include C here, and this will give us A and C. Now for this we need to calculate the look ahead symbol. Now this this production has been produced or has been included into the set 0, so because of this this operation, so here again we'll apply the same funda. So we need to calculate the follow of C. So follow of C will be generated as first of capital C comma dollar. So this will give you first of C dollar will give you A and D, because this will generate AD. So we can directly write here that A and D. Similar is the case with here also, we'll get A and D, because this C is also generated because of this dot C. That's why we are writing A and D as the look ahead symbol for these productions. So this will give you I0. Now on S we will write dollar. So you can notice here that the look ahead symbol is always traveling with the production itself. Now on capital C will move, so we'll get C dot C, and this dollar will move from here to this state. Now this C will give you dot A and capital C. So again, follow of C gives you dollar, that is first of dollar and epsilon, and this will also give you dollar dot D and dollar. I hope you are getting the concept of calculation of this will give you I2, this was I1. Calculation of that look ahead symbols. Now again next will be on small a, a dot C, we had A and D here. Now again this C will give you dot A C. Now this C and the follow of this C will get give you A and D, because first of A D and C dot D with A D as look ahead symbol. So this will give you I3, and finally here we on the D we will get D dollar, I mean D dot with look ahead symbol A and D. This will give you I4. So that's why I'm telling you that it consumes more memory, because the number of states generated are more here. And in the later session we'll discuss LALR, which is derived from LR, CLR parser only. So what happens in LALR parser, it will merge the states and it will reduce the complexity of the memory consumptions of LR parser, CLR parser. We'll discuss that LALR parser in our next video session. So C will give you S, C dot with dollar, and this will give you I5. And again on A we have C, A dot C with dollar, so we'll get dot AC with dollar and C dot D with dollar. So this will be I6. And again on D what we will get here, C D dot dollar, so this will be I7. And finally from this I3 what we can get here is on capital C we'll get AC dot with A and D as look ahead symbol. So this will give you I8. And on dot ACF, now if you see on small a, if we move then small a will lead to this only, and small d will give you this production. Now we have next on I6. So on I6 capital C will give you AC dot with dollar, this will be I9. On small a it will give you I6. You can say here that on A it will give you the I6. Where is I6? I6 is this one itself, so it will go here only. And on small d, if you move on small d you will get this I7. So this was I7, so we will get I7 here. And that's all, we have total 9 states here. Now let us construct the CLR parsing table. So based on this construction, I mean the whatever DFA we have constructed, so the entries for shift entries will be will remain same. So we had total 9 states, I0, I1, I2, I3, I9. So we had total 9 states. with A, D and dollar as terminal symbols and S and C as non-terminal symbols. So the shift entries, you know, if you don't know the shift entries, how to make the shift entries, please refer the previous videos. This will be accept. Then we have S6 here, S7 here, S3, S4, and for I6 we have S6 and S7. That's all. So these are all shift entries, and for go to actions we have 1 here and 2 here. For I2 we have 5, for I3 we have 8, and for I6 we have 9. Where is I6? This is I6, 9. Now we have to make the reduce entries. Now how to make the reduce entries? So based on this diagram, say for example the reduce entries for this I4. So we need to serialize the given productions. So let us name them 1, 2 and 3. So you can see that C gives D dot. So this is the third production. So this will be R3 on A and D on I4. So we can directly make on I4. What we can make is R3 on I4 on A and D. So we can directly write R3 on I4. So R3. Now we have I1 on, so this is accepted, we have written already, this is a shift operation or the accept operation on I1 on dollar. So again then I5 is again a reduce operation, so S gives CC. So S gives CC is nothing but the first, very first operation, R1 on I5. So we can directly write on I5 as R1. So R1 will be under I5 under D. Or no, we made a mistake, this is dollar. So we need to make it on dollar. So this R1 should not come here, it should come here under dollar. I hope you're getting the concept of placing the reduce entries in the CLR parsing table. So we have another entries for, again we have this C gives AC, this is R2 on 9. So we can directly write on I9 with a dollar. So on this I9, we can write R2, and on I7 it will be R3, and I8 on A will give you R2 and R2. So this was the complete parsing table generated from the given DFA, whatever we have generated now. So I hope you got the concept of placing the reduce entries. So based on the look ahead symbols associated with all the reduce entries, we are placing the reduce entries in the parsing table. And the same concept follows here, that we can directly say that this is a CLR parser as there are no multiple entries. Now we'll consider one more example here for practice purpose only. After that we'll discuss the reduce and shift reduce conflict. So we have given grammar as S gives S and S gives A. So let us generate the final one here, S dash dot S with dollar. This will lead to bracket S, and again it is generated from this, so we can place directly dollar here and dot A dollar. So this will lead to I0 state. On S you can directly write S dash as S dot dollar. So this is the I1 operation on bracket. So it will give you bracket, and dollar will remain same as it is moving from this state, and this S, this dot will generate the S. So look ahead symbol will be bracket, because first of this and dollar will give you bracket, and similarly for dot A also we get bracket. So this will be I2, and on A we get SA dot dollar. This will be I3. Now on I2 will move again on capital S. This will give you S with dollar. This will be I3, I4. On bracket we move. This gives you S with the bracket. And again this generates. So the for look ahead symbol will be bracket and A with the bracket. Don't get confused with these two states, because here the look ahead symbol is bracket and here it is dollar. That's why it differs. And this will mark as I5. And on A we get S as A dot with bracket. This will be I6. So we have I4, I5 and I6. So on from I4 we get on bracket, closing bracket with dollar. So this is again one more reduce entry, which will be numbered as I7 because I6 was the last. From here we can say that on S we get dollar with bracket. This is I8. And on bracket what we are getting is, on opening bracket we are getting the same I5. So from I8 again on closing bracket we get S dot with the bracket. So this is again one more reduce entry, which will be numbered as I9. And I guess we are done here. So again we'll construct the parsing table. So the parsing table will remain the same. I mean states are I0, I1, I2. I9, and the total number of symbols and the non-terminal symbols, we have A, opening bracket, closing bracket and the dollar with capital S as the non-terminal, which will be placed with go to actions. So shift actions will be S3, S2, for I2 we have S6, S5, for I4 we have S7 on closing bracket, S6, S5 for I5, then we have S9 for I8. That's all. And for dollar we have I1 as accept. And for this we have 1, for I2 we have 4, for I5 we have 8 here. And the reduce entries again, for I6 we have for closing bracket as R2. You can see here that if you number them as 1 and 2 here, this one 1 and this one 2, then we'll get for what we have written here is I6 has been R2 under closing bracket. So where is I6? I6. So R2 under closing bracket, we are entering R2. Similarly, for dollar, R1 under I7. R1 under I7. And for I9, we have under closing bracket as R1. So that's all. And again there are no multiple entries, so we can say that this is a CLR parser. Now let us concentrate on the shift reduce conflict, SR conflict. So in case of CLR parser, how to determine the shift reduce conflict? So there is a rule here. If we have a production in this form, say for example A gives alpha dot a beta with the look ahead symbol, and b gives gamma dot with a as look ahead symbol. If we have such state in our DFA, then you can notice here, if this a matches with this a, I mean this terminal and this terminal, I mean the look ahead symbol for the reduce entry, it matches the next incoming string of the shift operation, then this leads to SR conflict. And with RR conflict, we have, if the states are in the form of A alpha dot with X as look ahead symbol and B gives gamma dot with X as look ahead symbol, so this will lead to RR conflict. So if we have same look ahead symbol in both the reduce actions, then that leads to RR conflict. So in our next video session, we will be looking into the LALR parser, which is nothing but equivalent to CLR parser, CLR1 parser, where we will be merging the states into a single state to form the LALR parser. I hope you got the concept of CLR parser here. So for any queries and any questions if you have regarding this video or any other demands, please mail us at demand@gogetiit.com. Thanks for listening. Have a great day.